using NAND. Okay, so it means you can convert any gate using NAND. So that is why it is called NAND gate. So here, here in this slide, I'm showing you how to convert an inverter using NAND gate. So you see here, I'm showing some table and I'm showing the symbol also. So how your inverter symbol can be represented as NAND gate, you see here. You have NAND gate. So if you combine the two, you can combine the two input signal and then you give a single signal X, then you will get the invert X, complement of the X. So what is the property, what is the rule we are applying here is actually adimportant. Okay, so this table is actually clear, it is very clear from this table that which rule we are applying to implement the gate using NAND. Okay, so this already I discussed, but this table is very clear. That's why I thought that you note down this table and you please try to remember this table. So if you have the question in the exam that prove that NAND and NOR gate are universal gate, so what will you write? You will write the line that NAND gate is called universal gate because any gate can be implementing using this gate. Okay, and then you prove it. You prove it by showing this table and their realization. Okay, gate realization you will show like this. So your answer will complete. Okay, so if someone asks you the next thing is realizing gate using NOR only. So then you will write again why it is called NOR gate. Why NOR gate is called universal gate? Because any gate can be realized using NOR. Okay, that's why it is called universal gate. That definition you will write and then you will prove it by showing these realization. Okay, so you will show the table. So you will take the gate one by one. So here I am taking inverter and then I am taking AND, then I am taking OR. So here in every in these all gates I am showing here inverter AND OR and NAND also. So one thing, if suppose the question is you realize the function using NAND gate, NAND only, NOR only, so you can use this knowledge. So this conversion, if you remember, then you can directly convert the expression into the hardware circuit or logic circuit, right? So if you remember these individual gate realization, then you can easily draw any expression if you have and you know what operator is it is using, so you can directly map it. Okay, so this is one way. So you please practice for this realization using NAND and NOR. Okay, now yesterday I was telling you the NOR implementation and I told you the approach that you will start with the Boolean expression, you will convert the Boolean expression in the format A dot B bar. That I told you, you remember what I told you yesterday? I told you to write the expression in such a way. See, this was the implementation I told you yesterday. So what was the approach yesterday? My approach was the given expression I was converting in the format A plus B complement. So I applied the De Morgan's theorem many times and I come out with the expression form A plus B complement. The expression I finally got, it was A plus B complement. Then I implemented each term in the form of NOR gate. Okay, so because X plus Y bar is your NOR gate, X bar plus Z bar is your NOR gate, so I can map it from this expression. So this was the one approach. Means you will start with the Boolean expression and you will convert, you will apply the theorem, De Morgan theorem, and you will come out with the final expression that will be in this form A plus B complement. Okay, finally I got the A plus B complement form, then I realized. So this was the one approach. So you can follow it if you feel that this is simple. Now today I am going to tell you the simple approach, and you can easily understand also. So just you see, I draw to understand the thing, because I don't know what type of problem, what form of problem you will get in the exam. So I'm showing you all the approaches, so all the possibilities of the question. So suppose in the question, if truth table is given, then what will you do? You will draw the K-map based on the number of variable. You will draw the K-map. If suppose you have the SOP form in the problem, if suppose SOP form is given, then you will again, you will from SOP, you will draw the K-map. If suppose you have EOS form in the question, EOS form, then you will draw the K-map. And if suppose you have the Boolean expression, so if you have Boolean expression, then you will convert it into SOP form or POS canonical form, and then you will draw the K-map. So if you are comfortable in directly mapping the Boolean expression into the K-map, it is okay. But if you don't know how to map directly any Boolean expression that is in the standard form, then it just you don't take risk. Just you do one more step. You obtain the SOP form or POS canonical form, and then map the your K-map. Okay, draw the K-map. So four type of questions you may get. You may have truth table, you may have SOP form, you may have POS form, you may have Boolean expression. Then what will you do ultimately? You will draw the K-map. Why I am saying to draw the K-map? Why I am not saying to directly come out with the expression? Because our task is, as a good engineer, our task is to realize a circuit that must contain a less number of gates. Minimum circuit I require. That's why I am applying a method called K-map. Okay. So as I need NOR, so it is better to map 0. So you already, you know, if you have SOP form, so you know for what combination you have F equal to 1. So you will map the zeros, means the rest cases you will map in the K-map. So you are targeting here zeros. Okay. So remember that you will target the zeros, and then you will group the zeros, and you will obtain the expression. Just you remember, as you are grouping zeros and you need a NOR implementation, so you will always get the expression in the POS form. And then you draw the, directly you can draw, if you have POS form, you can directly map in the OR and network. Next, you will insert bubble pairs in the intermediate label, and then you will replace bubbled AND with NOR gate. Bubbled AND with NOR gate. Bubbled AND, or you can say invert AND. It is same. Bubbled AND or invert AND is same thing. Okay. So once you will put the bubble, so one bubble will already will combine with the first label OR gate. It will give you the NOR, and second label it will come invert AND. So you will convert the invert AND into the NOR by saying that, by applying De Morgan theorem, your invert AND is equivalent to NOR gate. So this approach we will use. So you see how easy it is and how you will get the correct answer. So same example I'm taking here. Yesterday I took this example. So you remember, so first step, what I said, whatever the form of question you have, so here you have the min terms, so you will map it in the K-map. But the thing you need to remember, that you need NOR, so you please don't write here C bar D, because I am targeting the POS form. So write the variables like this. Okay, so it will be easy for you to write the expression directly. You can write C bar D bar, but one more step you need to do later, because you will ultimately get the SOP form. So my target is POS form. So what I will do, I will draw a K-map for POS. So this time I'm using these literals. Okay. So you see that without any much effort, I'm getting the final expression. Okay. So you see, finally, if I'm mapping zeros, I'm getting directly. You see, A plus B bar, C, D is common, so it is removed. For this part, c plus d. For this quad, it is a complement plus b. For this quad, it is c complement plus d complement. You see, after three or four step, we got this step, but here you are getting directly from the K-map. So this is the beauty of the K-map. So next step, I said, you will go, once you will get the expression for f, you will map R and you will realize with R and, so you know that x plus y is actually your R. So each term you will map as in the R. So you see, a plus b bar I mapped with R, c bar plus d bar I mapped with R, a bar plus b I mapped with R, c plus d I mapped with R, and all terms are combined with the dots, so I mapped the AND gate. So this is the easy circuit I'm showing you here. Yesterday I told you that if you don't have the four input gate, so you need to realize the gate using two input or NOR gate or and NAND gate, whatever you require. So all circuit, if you required using only same type of gate, so you need to again distribute, use the distributed network for this AND gate. So for simplicity, if no one is asking you to realize only all same type of two input NOR gate, so you will write this answer. So this is a simple approach. Okay, so what I did in the next step, I placed the bubble pair. I shown in the flowchart, I placed the bubble pairs. I know, because bubble pair means complement and again complement, means no change. So I put here bubble, I put here bubble, in each intermediate line I put bubble. So you see, one bubble is compensated with the first level OR gate, so it becomes NOR automatically. The second level is now your bubbled AND or invert AND. And you know, as per the De Morgan's theorem, invert AND is equivalent to NOR. So just directly I replaced with the NOR gate. So this is my final circuit, and it is NOR implementation. Okay. So I hope this is the simple approach. Everyone, just tell me, is this the simple approach or yesterday approach was simple? Just respond so it will confirm, Meena, that you are connected with me, because I can't see that you are here or not. That's why I am asking. Okay, just respond okay or yes, so that it will confirm me that you are in here. Okay, now come to the NAND. Okay, come to the NAND. So NAND again, four type of problems you may have. You may have truth table, you may have SOP form, you may have POS form, you may have Boolean expression. So same thing you need to do, means first step you need to do is same, means draw the K-map. But your K-map should be special. You see, previously what I did in the K-map, I used the plus form of the variables. So here also we will do. So draw the K-map, but this time there is a change. I will map once. Okay, I will map once. I will group once. I will write the expression in SOP form. I will draw AND or network, and then I will insert bubble pairs in the intermediate level, and then I will replace the bubbled OR. This time you will get in second level bubbled OR. So you will replace that bubbled OR with the NAND gate, because you know that bubbled OR or invert OR is equivalent to NAND gate. So this will be again a simple approach, simple method. Okay, so let me take one example for NAND implementation. So you just note down this flow chart. I will tell you the second approach also, because if suppose someone asks you to follow that approach, so you should know. That's why I will tell you one example for the NAND implementation using Boolean algebra only. Okay, so one example I will take using this approach, one example I will take using Boolean algebra. Okay, so everyone note it, because you have to tally these steps also. So same example I am taking here. Same example. What I did in the nor. Sorry, this I should change here. So this example I am taking the same. The given function is in the form of min terms. So you see, first step I said you draw the k-map, but you see the difference in the k-map. This time I am writing c var d. So every time you should understand what you need actually. Okay, based on that you will choose the k-map. Got it? Then you will map the one. You will map the one. Directly you know that f function min terms are given. That means you know the cell numbers where you have one. So I will put one here. So this time I need to put one, m1, m2, m13, m14. Okay. So here you see no group is forming, so you will take it as a individual. Okay, and then I will write the expression. So I am taking individual because no pair is forming, so I need to take it individual. Okay, so here this group is, this is not a group, this is individual. So what will be the expression corresponding to this? AB. So you see the intersection, this is AB and this is c bar d. This is a b c d bar. This is a bar b bar c d bar. This is a bar b bar c bar d. So you please write the expression with each group or with each individual. Don't write group 1, group 2, group 3, because again you need to write this one or two more step. So it is better to show the expression in the k-map itself. Okay, don't write group 1, group 3, because you need to write two or one or two more step to mention that group 1 is this, group 2 is this, group 3 is this. So you can skip it by directly write the expression for each grouping or for each individual. Write the expression here. Okay. So now my function in the form of SOP. So you see, you have the first one. It is a bar b bar c bar d, a bar b bar c d bar, plus a b c bar d, plus a b c d bar. So if you don't have any means constraint, means you should realize the small circuit, or you should use only two input NAND gate, then you can directly map it, no issue. So you can follow the steps that I showed in the flowchart. What is the next step? Once you will get the function in the SOP form, so you see this is in the SOP form, so directly map it into the AND or circuit. Okay, so directly I am mapping each term. So each term you will take. So in each term you see there are four variables. So you need to take it directly. So no need to apply your mind, just take the variables directly and map. So four terms are there, so that means you need four input, four AND gate. So each term I am mapping into the AND, because the product, the operator here is AND. That's why I am using directly. So whatever my variable I am directly writing here, I am not bothering it is complement or it is not. I am assuming that complement of each variable is available to me. So straightforward, if I no constraint is given to me, so I can directly map it first as an AND OR, and second you see all terms are connected with the plus, so I will connect with the OR gate. What is this? What is this realization? What is this realization? This is AND OR realization. First level is of, it is of AND gate, and second level is your OR gate. So that's why I am saying it is AND OR realization. So this is the simple approach if you don't have any constraint. Then next step is put the bubble pair in the intermediate line. So what, where is the intermediate line? Intermediate line is this. Okay, so you will put bubble pair. So this is the next step, and this bubble pair, what it does, it converted your first level AND gate into NAND gate. You see, so your first level is now converted into NAND gate, and second level it is converted into the bubbled OR gate, invert OR gate. So you know that this invert OR gate is equivalent to NAND gate. So this NOR is now you become NAND gate. So you can again, you can draw the circuit and you change this symbol with the NAND. So this is final. Or if I will say that you should draw the circuit using two input NAND only, then what will you do? Here you need a four input NAND gate for each. So it is good that you have four term and you have four input four variables in each term. So it is good that you need a similar type of NAND gate. So the good thing in this circuit is you need a similar four input NAND gate. So if you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 NAND gate, your circuit will be formed. So 5 numbers of 4 input NAND gate is required. So similarity is there in the gate. So this is again a good thing, that I want to draw a circuit that should follow the uniformity. As a good design engineer, we should take care of that your circuit should be of, is as much as possible, your circuit should be of, consist of similar type of gates. You please listen my words carefully. The good designer means you should follow some constraint. Your circuit should be consist of same type of gate, means uniformity should be there, or you can say regularity should be there. Okay, so this you please remember, your effort should be that you should get a circuit that contains similar type of gates. So this is good in this circuit, that automatically you have a similar type of gate requirement. 5 number of NAND gate is sufficient to implement this circuit. Okay. Now come to the second approach. So here in this approach, I will tell you another example. So note down this example. Let's say you have. So this is the example I'm taking from Maurice Menno. And this is a different question also, that it is not a standard form, it is not a pure SOP or QS form. So you see here, so this is a special question, it is a non-standard form. So for non-standard form, it will be easy to follow the Boolean expression minimization conversion approach, because in two or three steps you will get the expression that is equivalent to your NAND gate function. Okay, so here I am telling you the another approach. Just note down this question. This is a non-standard form. Why I am saying this is non-standard? Because it contains both operators, but it is not fixed here that it is first it is taking the dot operation with the W and X plus Y plus Z. So if you are simplifying the expression, means if you are multiplying inside W X and then you are writing plus W Y plus W Z, so this will become a SOP form. Okay, standard form SOP. If you multiply this W with the X, then you will get the this WX plus WY plus WZ plus XYZ. You see, each term is first ended and then it is OR. So this is your standard form SOP. But what is this? Here you see, if you are implementing this circuit and if you are implementing this circuit, both circuit will be different. Okay, connectivity will be different. So that's why I am telling you this is a non-standard circuit, non-standard form. So if suppose you are realizing this circuit directly, you will get multi-level circuit. You will get multi-level circuit. Okay, here you will get two level circuit. Got it? So implementation, hardware implementation of this expression and hardware implementation of this expression will be different. Though it is for same function, it will give you same output, but the connectivity of the gates and the type of the gate in the circuit will be different. You understand? If you want to directly map it, whatever expression it is written, just you please map it. So you see, I am drawing a circuit. So your doubt that how to draw the Boolean expression in the form of hardware. So I am telling you, I am first drawing here the circuit. So I am not telling you the NAND and circuit. I am telling you the general approach for hardware realization. So how to get the hardware directly. So I am telling you, it is not a question that is you realize the NAND and only. I am telling you the approach. What is the difference in these two expression? So I am first mapping this expression here. So you see, one by one I will take term. So you see, this is X plus Y plus Z. That means I need a OR gate. So this OR gate will give you the X plus Y plus Z. You see. And then you are you see that this X plus Y Z is now dot with the W. So what I am taking, this already generated X plus Y plus Z, and I am ORing, I am ending with the. I am looking at the operator. I am replacing with the gates. This is the simple approach for hardware realization. So you see what you get now in the output. What will you get? You will get this okay, you will get this. And what is this? This is your XYZ. That means you need a AND gate, and you will give XYZ. And this XYZ is now OR with the this term. So that means this term you will take, and you will combine with this output, and it is connected with the plus sign. So you will use OR gate. So finally, you will get a single output. That is your F. So you see. Each line I am writing the expression, so you can understand what I did here. So you see that it is a multi-level realization, multi-level gate logic circuit realization, multi-level gate circuit realization. Okay, so this is a Boolean expression implementation, means hardware implementation, but it is multi-level. Now see this expression. Now I am mapping this expression into the hardware. You see. So I am writing the function here again, so that you will see what is the difference in the realization. So this is my this is my standard form SOP. So you see that each term you have, so you will map it to your W, X, W, Y, W, Z. X, Y, Z. Oh, sorry. And all terms are connected with the plus sign, so I am using a OR gate. So if you want to directly, if you want to implement a circuit using the previous approach, you see here, now you have the AND OR implementation. So it is easy to convert this AND OR implementation into NAND NAND, right? What will you do? If you have the SOP form, you can directly map in the AND OR. Okay, then you put the bubbles. So this is the simple straightforward implementation of this given Boolean function into the AND OR or into the multi-level gate circuit, okay? Okay, but now my question was, if someone asks you to draw the NAND NAND only, so NAND NAND only, as I said, you better to get the SOP form and then draw. So this is the approach. You just put the bubble. So first level automatically will convert into NAND, and second level will be your bubbled OR. So you can replace this bubbled OR with the NAND. So automatically you will get directly from this expression in the NAND NAND form. But now I am telling you the approach in which you will use only Boolean expression. So you will use Boolean expression. How we can use? Let's see. So this is, I am showing you the second approach. First approach I already showed you. So first I will do, my task is NAND NAND. That means I will, task is to get the form of the expression in, like this. A dot B complement, because I know that if I will give A, if I will give B, then it will be complement. So this will be my NAND gate, and its output will be A dot B complement. So this is the concept I know. So what is my task here? I will convert a form of this function in such a manner, A dot B complement. Okay. So what I am doing here, I am doing complement first, because here no complement is there. A dot B is here, means you, if you assume it A, if you assume it B, you know this is a AND gate, but this is not the NAND gate. Okay, no complement is there. So what I am doing, I am first complementing. So I am putting complement here. What will it will do? Just you see the thing. So if I am doing complement here in the left hand side, again you need to add complement on the right hand side also. Now I am applying a De Morgan theorem. What De Morgan theorem states? That if A plus B complement, that means you have A complement dot B complement. Okay, so I am assuming this as A I am assuming this as B. Okay, so this is my A plus B complement. So I am replacing this A plus B complement with the A complement B complement. What is A? My A is A dot X plus Y plus Z and its complement dot X, Y, Z complement. Okay, so this is my A, this is my B. Okay, so you see, so you see that your second term is now in the form of NAND. Okay, so no need to touch this term. So because I already get the NAND term, so I will not touch this X, Y, Z bar. Now I will treat this term. Apply De Morgan theorem here. Again, I will apply De Morgan theorem here. So you assume now this time A, and this time it is B. So if you will apply this, so you will, what will you get? A W bar plus X Y Z bar, because this X plus Y plus Z is you need to write it X plus. So this X plus plus will be there, it will remain same. So this let me remove it. If I will implement, this is A dot B complement. Okay, so A dot B complement means you need to treat this term only, because it is A, it is B. So A dot B complement you already have, so no need to touch it. So I will concentrate on this term. So what I will do, I will put a double bar here in this term. No change, as I am using two complements, so no change in the expression, but it will help me to get the form of A dot B. Okay, so you convert this you retain this complement here, and you convert this, you apply the De Morgan theorem in this part. So X plus Y plus Z complement is actually your X complement, Y complement, Z complement. So you see that now it is in the form of NAND gate. So you can now implement this circuit. So everywhere you see that it is in the form of A dot B complement. So now it is ready to draw the circuit. So what I will do, so this is your one NAND gate. So I will map it first, X, Y, Z. And this, again, this is the NAND gate, but here the difference is, what is the difference here in this expression? This NAND gate has input X complement, Y complement, Z complement. So you will get this output, X complement, Y complement, Z complement, common bar. So this NAND will give you this. This NAND will give you this. And the output of this NAND gate is now combined with the W. Okay, so this will give you X dot Y dot dot W complement. So this is the term you will get. Okay, and then these two terms are connected with the NAND, with the AND, sorry. But you know that what I am implementing actually, I am implementing F complement, you know. What is this? You know that what I started from the this f complement. So what is this? Actually your f complement. So if you are drawing the end here, it is giving you the f complement. That means if I will put a inverter here, then it will convert into the NAND. Okay, so finally you will get the f here. Everyone understand what I did here? I implemented the f complement and then I put bubble here to get the f. So you see, first stage is automatically converted into the NAND. Second stage, your AND is now combined with the bubble, so it will become NAND. So see, total circuit is now consist of NAND only, but it is multi-level. It is multi-level. Three levels are there. Any doubt in this explanation, or shall I repeat again? Answer.
Once again, repeat, ma'am.
Once repeat, ma'am.
Repeat. Okay. What I said to you, that I want the for, because I know that your gate NAND gate expression is this. So my form of this expression should be like this. Okay. So you know that no complement is here. So I will introduce the complement first. So I am taking the complement of the function, because I know that if I have the f complement, I will invert it by applying one inverter at the end. Okay, no issue. So what I am doing here, I am making complement both side. Okay. So what I did, I took complement and then I applied the Boolean theorem. So Boolean theorem, what is it? It states that if A plus B complement, it can be A complement B complement. So that theorem I am using here. You assume that this is A, you assume that this is B. So this is A plus B complement. So I am applying this theorem here. So what is A here? A is my W dot X plus Y plus Z, and what I need to write? A complement. So I will put bar here. Dot. What is B? B is my X, Y, Z. So I need to write B complement. So I am writing X, Y, Z complement. Got it? So just I am directly applying the theorem. Next step, you see that this is my form already. So no need to touch it, because it is now forming my NAND gate. So no need to change it further. So I will now treat this. So you see that if I am assuming it as A and if I am assuming it as B, so you see it is A dot B complement. So again, if I am taking this term directly, again it is forming the NAND gate, no problem. But the point is, this plus sign is there. So what is the thing you are looking here? That actually you need to replace plus sign. So how can you replace the plus sign? You will apply De Morgan theorem again and again. So you see that this dot is already there, so no need to touch this term. So what I will do, I will touch this, the plus signs are there, so I will only see this expression, X plus Y plus Z. So what I did, I put the double complement here in this expression. So no change, you know that. So no change in the expression, but it will help me to convert the form of the expression. So I put double complement here because I want to remove the plus sign. So again, I want to apply the De Morgan theorem. Okay. So De Morgan theorem, you know that this is the form of De Morgan theorem. I am again applying here. So W, I am taking as it is. And this upper complement, it will retain. And this lower complement, you will see that this is here you can apply. So what I am doing here, so I am taking X plus Y plus Z complement here, and I will convert this X plus Y Z as per the De Morgan theorem. It is X complement, Y complement, Z. So individual complement will be there as per De Morgan theorem. So what I did, internal complement I have taken here, and I applied the De Morgan theorem. Got it? So this term, this complement X plus Y Z, I am now replacing with the X complement, Y complement, Z complement dot X, Y, Z. So what you found here? no plus sign is there. Okay, so if you want NAND implementation, your task is to convert a Boolean expression in such a manner it should not contain any plus sign. So this is the conclusion for the transformation. So I implemented F, I treated F complement, and I come out with the term that contains only dot. You see, only AND operators are there, no plus operator is there. So this you should remember, that if you want to follow this approach, your task is to remove all plus signs. So how you can remove the plus sign? You apply again and again De Morgan theorem. Any plus sign if you have, you replace this with the A complement, B complement. Every time you will use this theorem. So same thing you will use for NOR. You will remove the dot sign by applying the A dot B complement as A dot B complement as A complement plus B complement. Okay. So you see in the expression that now we can implement. So you see this is itself a NAND gate. So this is a NAND gate, because if I am giving XYZ, it will give you the complement. So see the function also for NAND gate. The function is this. Second term I am replacing this X bar, Y bar, and it is again complement. So you can take it X complement, Y complement, Z complement, and you will put bubble, because this red line is there. That means you need to put complement here. So this is again automatically your NAND gate. So what it is actually giving you? It is giving you this. So you see how I am replacing the term in the form of hardware. Now my next task is, this output is now connected with the W. So I will connect with the W. So this is my output and this is your W. Again you need a NAND gate, because again your W and this term is now it is complemented. So this is a NAND form, A plus B form. You see, if you assume it as A, if you assume it as B, so again it is A dot B complement. So this is your NAND gate. So what it is actually giving you? A W dot X complement, Y complement, Z complement. So this is your final output you will get from here. And now these two terms are combined with the dot. So actually you are combining here. So what you are getting actually? You are getting F complement here. So what I am actually implementing? I am implementing F complement. But what I found here, that last AND gate, it is AND gate. And I am asking only NAND gate. So what I will do? I will put one complement here, one inverter. If you put one inverter, so one inverter, after complementing, what it will give you? F only. This is required. Okay, so you see that this inverter you can combine as a, if you combine this inverter and AND gate, what will you get? You will get the NAND gate. So whatever be the things you are getting here, you will give to the NAND gate, and you will get the F. Okay. Any step you feel that you are unable to understand in this explanation, you ask. Any step you feel you are unable to understand, you ask. Everyone connected to me now?
Clear, ma'am.
Is it clear? Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Clear, ma'am.
Okay. So these are the problem for today. I will give you one practice sheet to do the hardware realization. So if you see the Morris Menno, I shared the chapter of the Morris Menno on the WhatsApp.